Let the church say amen. Amen. If you love calling on his name, if he brought you out of a horrible pit and a miry clay and set your feet upon a rock, could we just give a shout of praise? Hallelujah. Glory, glory to that mighty name of Jesus. I don't know where I'd be if it wasn't for him. And so I am glad right now. And as you should be, that the saints of God, once again, we can assemble ourselves. God has given us the freedom, even in this land, in this world, just to assemble ourselves together as God's saints, his servants, his friends, to worship him in spirit and in truth, to sing the songs of Zion, to hear the word of God preached. We ought to give him a shout of praise and thanks this morning. I know Thanksgiving is a few days away, but someone said that every day is a day of Thanksgiving. So, to God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be all of the glory. Amen. Our responsive reading comes from Isaiah chapter 40, verses 28 to 31. If you're like me, sometimes you just like to look at it and read it for yourself. That's okay. I'll give you a couple of minutes to turn there. But we have it here on the screen. And if you're turning there and you're familiar with it there, you'll find written these words. Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary? There is no searching of his understanding. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall altogether. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Might we pray? Eternal God, our Father, in the name and the authority of Jesus, who is the Christ. God, we come before your throne this morning, understanding that you are God and you're God alone. You are the great I am. Oh, great Jehovah, we come understanding that it's in you that we live and move and have our being. There's none like unto you. There's none above you. God, we just thank you that you made us and not we ourselves. And God, you brought us to this hour. Thanking you for salvation that's rich and free, Lord Jesus, because it was you. It was not Moses, not David or Isaiah that went to Calvary's cross. You died. You shed your blood that we might be saved by grace through faith. And for that, we say, thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you that we can be saved and know it, knowing that we have a home in heaven. And oh God, we seek your face today, not so much your hand. We just say thank you and for just everything. Every gift comes from you. Every great gift, every great marvelous gift comes from you. And we understand it. We understand that you brought us to this hour. You woke us up this morning, not the alarm clock. with a roof over our heads, food to eat, clothes to put on our back. Gracious God, we bless your holy name this morning. Heavenly Father, we do thank you and for everything, but Father, we do come asking, Lord, for these things that I'm about to lay before your throne, praying that, Lord, you would do it according to your will and your way, but that you might get all the praise and all the honor and the glory for what's accomplished. God, I come praying for those who are in our midst or wanted to be here but could not because of an affliction. Father, would you deliver? Would you heal? We know that you can. We just come praying that you would do it in the name of Jesus. That someone might come and say, God has healed me. He did it. God, we do thank you for caregivers, doctors, and those who are caring for us. But Father, we know that you can heal. You can do the miraculous. Father, someone in our midst, we know we have those bereaved here. So Father, would you comfort them? Give understanding. A supernatural understanding comes only from you. Father, meet the needs of those who someone might need a job, or there's some type of a conflict or controversy on the job or in the neighborhood, in the home. Bind the enemy right now in the name of Jesus. God, we just thank you in advance for what you're going to do. Thanking you for this great church, our pastor, his wife, all of our auxiliaries. Lord, we just thank you that we can be a part of what you're doing in this world. And Lord Jesus, as you tarry, you're coming. God, help us. Keep us in the hollow of your hand. We might be that church that this neighborhood needs so desperately. And so, Father, we just once again thank you for what you're going to do in these areas. God, when you do any or all of these things, would you be so careful to give you all of the praise, all of the honor, all of the glory? You're so deserving of it. And we're praying all these things and asking them in the precious name of Jesus Christ, who is Lord and Savior and Redeemer. Amen. 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 And amen.
Come on, bless and praise our God. Come on. Where the folks at that can't stop praising his name? Anybody know him? I said, did anybody know him? Where my worshipers at? Who know you just can't stop praising his name. The more I think about it, the more I want to praise him. Can't stop praising his name. I just can't stop praising his name. Come on, bless and praise our God. Amen. And let's show some love to this amazing choir music ministry. Thank you for leading us in worship this morning. I feel better after Can't Stop praising his name. Amen. Sound like you all came for worship. Thank our mothers for wonderful devotion, and Reverend Railford for leading us to the altar. Yeah. Now we have a word from the Lord. Yeah. If you're able to stand with us for the reading, reverence and respect for God's word. Psalms 60, verse 1 through 12. We got time to read all 12 verses. O God, thou hast cast us off, thou hast scattered us, thou hast been displeased. O turn thyself to us again.
Thou hast
broken it, healed the priest of Israel, O shame. Thou hast shewed thee people hard things, thou hast made us to drink the wine of astonishment. That thou, beloved, may be delivered, save with thy right hand, and hear me.
God has spoken in his holiness. I will rejoice. I will divide Shechem and lead out the valley of Succoth.
Gilead is mine, Manasseh is mine, Ephraim also is the strength of my head, Judah is my lawgiver. Who will bring me unto the strong city? Who will lead me unto Edom? Give us help from trouble, for vain is the help of man. Together. Amen. God bless you. I want to tag text with the subject, when you suffer setbacks. When you suffer setbacks. It happens to the best of us. Defeat, disappointment. When things don't go according to plan, setbacks, defeats are a part of life. We have experienced it with relationships, our careers, our finances, and even our personal growth.
Yes, sir, Reverend. Yes, sir.
Life is filled with ups and downs, highs and lows. How we respond will determine our outcome.
Yes.
However, there are some who never recover from certain setbacks. Others have come to the place to understand the setback is only a setup for your comeback. But there are others who have been so devastated by their setbacks. Ever been set back? Disappointed? A feeling of failure and defeat? Particularly when you've done your best and given your all and have defeat slap you in the face. Giving yourself to a job, an occupation, and only to have a setback of not promotion, but demotion. Life becomes critical when we have to deal with these ups and downs and highs and lows, and there are others who manage them better than others who have difficulty in managing these setbacks. Sometimes a relationship will set us back 5-10 years before we can recover, laugh again, smile again, be our true self. Sometimes it's the death of a loved one, the loss of a loved one can set us back. But I want to give us a word today that will help us when we experience setbacks, when we experience defeat. Because, ladies and gentlemen, just as victory is coming, defeat will show up as well. And you got to know when defeat shows up, you got to know who you are and whose you are and how you're going to interpret this setback. I see a setback as only a temporary situation. I see a setback as only a setup for my comeback. Oh yeah, there will be a comeback because I have resurrection power within me. Well, our text again brings us to David, and we don't understand, or at least theologians and scholars gives us no idea of what his particular setback is. This is called a Mishtam Psalms, which means a golden psalm. It's a psalm that should be revered and remembered, and it is known to be worthy of preserving. His setback is not only damaging, but it's damaging to the point where he feels God has rejected him. How do we deal with life when life smacks us down, but then we feel, God, you got something to do with it? Because you have rejected me. And ladies and gentlemen, I can deal with the rejection of men, but I can't deal with the rejection of God. Lord, don't you leave me. Don't you leave me by myself. I need your presence. I need your power, because I can make it without folks. But I can't make it without you. I can make it without income, but I can't make it without you. I can make it without family and friends, but I need you in my life. And this becomes critical because David declares, God, why have you forsaken us? Why have you rejected us? So much so, if you still have your Bibles open, Verse 2 says this feeling is just like an earthquake. That my foundation has crumbled because I feel rejection from you. I don't know who I'm talking to who pray and feel like God don't hear you when you pray. Who am I talking to when you worship, you feel like God is not paying your worship any attention? Who am I talking to who have devoted yourself to ministry, but yet you don't feel the calling of God on your life? Where are my folks at in this house who have ever experienced walking in the presence of God, but now it feels like the favor of God has left your life? David says it's like an earthquake. My foundation has been shaken. But not only like an earthquake, verse 3, he declares, is like a drunken man. That we are intoxicated with confusion. Because we wondering, what in the world is going on? Where is God when we need him? We are so confused. We are drunk with confusion. Our earth has been shaken and our world has been turned upside down. But verse 4, he has a little hope there. He speaks of the presence of God. Isn't that where we are? And regardless what happens as a child of God, we know God, you somewhere in this. I may can't feel you or see you right now, and I might feel rejected, but God, I know you're somewhere in this. Can't put my hand on it right now. I don't understand everything right now, but God, I know you don't hadn't left me. I feel like you left me, but my mind tells me you hadn't left me. And I know that there's a God somewhere, and I know that you are still in the midst of my situation and my circumstances. When setback shows up, David gives us at least four moves in this psalm. Verse 5, he gives us a remedy. When setbacks show up, the first thing I see here is that he requests restoration. When setback, defeat, and feeling rejected shows up, cry out unto the Lord. Here is the problem for some of y'all. Some of y'all are too strong. Yeah. You used to handling your own business and fixing your own situation. But can I tell you, life is not meant for you and I to handle it alone. Who in this house who have lived long enough to know you need some help? I like this church this morning. I don't care how spiritual you are, how educated you are, how many Bible verses you know, we all need some help. You need some help with your spouse. You need some help with your children. You need help with your relationship. Listen, you need help with yourself. Come on, talk to me here. And we've got to learn how to cry out and say, Lord, help me. Quit being so masculine and macho. Think you can handle it. And it's handling you. Thinking you can deal with it and it's dealing with you. Cast all your cares upon me, because I care for you. God is able to carry your heavy load. Stop trying to do it all by yourself. Stop trying to carry it by yourself. And when we feel defeat, setback, and rejection, that hurts, y'all. Stop acting like everything is all right when it ain't all right. I know when folks ask you how you doing, we quick to say we doing good, but everybody don't need to know your business no way. I understand. But you ought at least be honest with yourself and speak truth to yourself and say, Lord, if you don't help me, I can't stand the storm. Lord, if you don't show up, I'm through it. Lord, if you don't come through, I ain't gonna make it. I need your help. You'll have a mental breakdown. You'll have frustration and anxiety that you cannot carry and bear. I'm glad to report to you that we got a God. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and grief to bear. Oh, I believe I feel like preaching this morning. What a privilege it is to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forsake. Oh, what needless pains we bear. It's all because we do not carry everything. 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 I say everything, every little thing, everything to God in, in prayer. So you got your setback, feeling defeat, feeling even rejected by God. Requests restoration. That's what David does in verse 5. He cries out, save me with thy right hand. Hear me. He cries out to God. But then, secondly, rejoice in his promise. I didn't say rejoice in the problem. Rejoice in the promise. Where do you see the promise? Look at verse 6. God has spoken in holiness. God has spoken. Ladies and gentlemen, you ought to read the word of God. And you ought to mark in your Bible wherever you see promises of God. When you read and see the promises of God, you ought to mark God's promises. You ought to have a praise party at the house just off the promises of God. Do you know the promises of God? Do you know what he has promised? Now, I don't want to go through the litany of promises, but let me share. Everything he promised is going to come to pass. And there are some promises we have lived to see. Let me give you one of my favorites. I've been young. Now I'm old. I've never seen the righteous forsaken or their seed begging bread. I've lived long enough to see that. I've lived long enough to see God's hand in that. And whenever God has promised, it reminds us that the deal is still on. This is where the shout come in. You messed up your end of the bark. But he kept his. I see I got about 25 of y'all riding with me here. You sin, you fail, you came short of the glory. But in spite of you, what he has promised, he still fulfilled. He's so much God, he cannot deny himself. He cannot deny his word. Whatever he says, it will come to pass. And so we have to focus on his promises. I know the setback hurt. I know the defeat hurt. And the feeling of rejection, but I got something here I can hold on to. I can hold on to God's word. And if I hold to his word, sooner or later, it will come to pass. It will turn around. I wish I had about 8 of y'all who are standing on his promise. Who have lived long enough to know his word to be true. Boy, I wish I had time to stay there, but you got to know something about the word of God. I thank God for his word. His word is what keeps me. And everything around me is falling apart. Word is what keeps my mind, my heart, so I won't go snap, crackle, and pop. His word is what gives me foundation. And everything is crumbling. You need his word. But not only rejoice in his promise, but remember his power. Verse 7 and 8, he starts speaking of his land. Look what he says. Gilead is mine. Manassas is mine. Ephraim also is my strength. And Judah is my lawgiver. Not only is the land, he speaks of the land in verse 6, where he speaks of Shechem and Succoth. He speaks of the land, but not only is the land his, you are his. And then in verse 8, he starts talking about the enemies that they're facing. Moab is my washpot. Edom will I cast out my shoe, and Philistia, triumph thou because of me. He speaks in terms of his power. That he has power over the enemy. He has power over their situations and over their circumstances. And so when setback and defeat and rejection show up, we must remember who he is. That's why I like that Isaiah piece so well, because that Isaiah piece that we read during responsive reading, he asks the question, "Hast thou not known?" Let me hop rise here. Y'all done forgot? Y'all don't know who he is. And see, that's why you need to come to worship and Bible study and Sunday school, because we need these reminders of who God is. Because when life and the world and society start beating us up, and you get the reminder of who he is, you are able to deal with the blows and punches of life because you know something about the power of your God. And you know what your God has done. And you know what he will do and what he is doing. But if you get a good, healthy understanding of what he's already done, you know he will forever do. That's why we shout off these old biblical stories, because it gives us an understanding what he's already done. And somebody know if he did it once, y'all ought to help me preach it. If he did it once, if he healed you one time, if he brought you out before, if he made a way out of no way, he'll do it again. Won't he do it? I said, won't he do it? Just on what he did on yesterday. Give me enough to know that he's able to take care of today and tomorrow. He's able to take care next week, next month, and next year. Ain't it all right? Yeah. But let me leave you when I tell you. When setback shows up, request restoration. Rejoice in his promises. Not problem, but the promise. Remember his power. Remember what he's already done. If he brought you out then, he'll do it again. Truth of the matter, this ain't first time you lost a job. This ain't first time folks have broke your heart. Just as he restored you then, he'll do it again. But let me leave you when I tell you, rest in his deliverance. 9:10, he says, verse 12, through God, we shall do valiantly, meaning mighty. It also means strength. The comeback is inevitable. We're not relying on our own strength. That through the strength and power of God, we will bounce back. Anybody feeling a comeback in your spirit? Anybody feeling a bounce back? Now I need those who have been set back to help me close here. Now if this ain't you, don't you say nothing here. But I need those who have been set back, who've been defeated and have dealt with some fear. But deep in your spirit, you feel a comeback. You feel a bounce back. You feel a Terminator spirit. An Arnold Schwarzenegger. You say to your haters, to your enemies, and the people who thought you were buried and left for dead, come on, say it with your Terminator voice. I'll be back. And the reason we can say we're gonna be back, because we got a resurrection power on the inside. The same power that raised up a dead Jesus
It lives in you. That's why we can say we're troubled on every side, but we ain't distressed. We're perplexed, but we're not in despair. We are persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Can I tell you why? God has made us to come back, bounce back, and to resurrect just like a basketball. The harder you bounce it, the higher it goes. If the devil only knew that the setback is a setup for my comeback. The harder I went down, the farther I went down, God will give me resurrection power to rise again. New hope, help me be a witness in this place. I need those who have bounced back, come back from darkness, come back from a low place. I need my divorcees to help me be a witness. God will give you renewed life and strength. I need those of you who've messed up in life and people didn't think you would ever come back. They've even wrote the benediction on your life, but they didn't know God had the last word. God is able to lift you and raise you up above your wildest imagination. Where my folks at in this place who've been sick and the doctors couldn't do you no good? Medicine couldn't help you, but God raise you up to the point the doctors don't understand. Ain't it all right? Ain't it all right? Where my folks in this place who have lost a job? They fired you, laid you off, and you cried about it. But God only close one door so he can open another door. And now you're here saying, I'm better. I'm so much better. I want to thank you for closing those doors, because I never would have been where I am if it had not been for you. Where my folks in this place who've gone through a breakup, a relationship that broke your heart, but God had a ram in the bush. God had another. He always got another. He's got another sweetheart. He's got another boo. I ain't gonna cry over spilled milk. I'm learning to thank God for the ups and the downs. for the high and the low, because I know you're working it out. All things for my good. And if good hadn't shown up, hold on, give it a few more days, because weeping may endure for a night, but I got company in the morning. In the morning, joy, joy, joy. Good morning, new hope. May the Lord bless you real good. But the next time you have a setback, I want you to take some time and lift up your eyes to heaven and tell the Lord, I don't know what you're doing, but Lord, I trust you. I trust you to turn it around. I trust you to set me up. I trust you for a breakthrough. I trust you for a miracle. I know you're working all things for my good. Work it out, Jesus, work it out. Come on, Jesus, work it out, won't it do it? I know he's all right. I know he's all right. I know he's all right. I know he's all right.
Come on, stand. Stand all over the house. I don't know who that message was for, but your setback is just a setup. It's really a blessing in disguise. Some of you have lived long enough to look back and say, God, I understand it now. You was just setting me up. I didn't have sense enough to walk out of a toxic relationship. I didn't have sense enough to leave a stressful job. I didn't have sense enough to do for myself. But you shifted, moved, navigated, and brought me to a place that now I know, now I see. Now I got a little Marvin Sapp in me now. Never would have made it. Never would have made it. Never would have made it. Oh. And I'm smarter. I'm wiser. I'm stronger. I'm so much stronger. Oh, bless his name. Come on, we extend the invitation. If you're here out of church, need a church home, New Hope would love to have you as a part of this body of Christ. I would love to be your pastor. There are people standing beside you would love to be your sister and brother. Lord has touched your heart. Come on, move now. Time does not permit us to continue to wait, but you can make today your day. The choice is yours, the decision is yours. We don't want to force, make anybody come, but if God is speaking to your heart, let me give you the answer. They said it in devotion. Yes, Lord. Let the church say yes. Say yes in your heart. Say yes in your spirit. Life will never be the same. Amen, amen. Come on, put our hands together. Bless and praise our God. Let us now prepare to go to the table of God as we reflect on our Savior, what he did for us. Jesus, I'll never forget what you've done for me. Traditional church would do this every first Sunday, but we've come to know that every day is a day of thanksgiving. And the word says, as often as you do this. And so New Hope, we try to do it every Sunday, every chance we get to remember and to reflect on Christ. Let's go to God in prayer. Lord, we thank you again for the awesome gift of Jesus Christ. Where would we be without your power, without your presence, and without your provision? We're grateful now that when setbacks happen in our life, we know we can resurrect because our Savior resurrected. Came back from the clutches of death and hell. And he's given us life and life more abundantly. So, Lord, we say thank you. Bless us now as we prepare to eat and drink. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Would that you receive a cup, hold it for further instruction.
The blood that gives me strength from day to day, it will never lose its power. The blood that Jesus shed for me, way back on Calvary. Oh, yeah. Oh, the blood that gives me strength from day to day, it will never. and it reaches to the highest mountain. Oh, and it flows to the lowest valley. Oh, yeah. Oh, the blood that gives me strength from day to day.
Amen, amen. If we will take the bread, let's lift the bread together. And he took bread, gave thanks, broke it, gave it unto them, saying, this is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me. God, we say thank you for power of your broken body. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us eat. Carefully lifting the cup. Likewise, also the cup after supper, saying, this is cup in the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you. God, we thank you for power of your blood that shall never ever lose its power. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us drink. Say amen.
Amen.
Come on, say amen again. What if I say it's given time? It's given time. Before our ushers come, before our ushers move, our ushers got some bad vests on this morning. Looking like Secret Service. Yeah. What y'all got under them vests? Amen. All right. Had a member that say to me, I don't like to come to church when I don't have any money. And I said to her, don't let that stop you. Because God is never requiring anything he does not give you. And if God hadn't blessed you, if he'd given you anything, you just bring your broke self on to church and have worship. And when we lift our gift, we're not trying to shame anybody or guilt anybody. It's just a matter of being a witness. Just like in the sermon, you stand up, you say amen, you are witness to a truth. And those of us who are witness to the truth of giving, We want to demonstrate it as being a witness and a testimony that God will bless you when you give. Amen. Amen. Urshas are coming. Urshas are on their way. Let's get a good gift in our hand to represent our tithes and offering. And let's, I want to thank you again for your generous love gift. Thank you for blessing me. If I have been a blessing to you, you feel it not robbery to be a blessing to me. Scripture says you will be blessed with a prophet's reward. Amen. Amen. Thank you so very, very much. Couple announcements. This Wednesday, say this Wednesday. This Wednesday, 6 o'clock, you don't have to dress up. You can come right after you leave work or school or whatever the case may be. This is our pre-Thanksgiving worship. And so we would that everybody will be in place. You don't want to have Thanksgiving until you have Thanksgiving worship. Amen? The turkey, the dressing, everything tastes better when you come to worship. Pre-Thanksgiving worship, amen? So we're looking to see everyone 6 o'clock Wednesday night for pre-Thanksgiving worship. We'll not have intercessory prayer or Sunday school or new membership. We're coming for worship that night, and we're coming to give thanks to God corporately, amen? So we need all the bells and whistles. We need everybody in place. Choir, musicians, ushers, deacons, mothers, everybody, all right? So let's do our best to be here Wednesday night. Then Friday, we're having our movie night. Movie night is at what time? 7 o'clock? 7 o'clock movie night. And the men has made it very economical and convenient for us. I think it's $10, and you get a whole lot for $10. Can't beat that. And you'll have a nice time fellowshipping and a good time for you to bring a date and won't have to spend a whole lot. You'll be like you're a boss in there. You'll be a boss in there. $10 will just make you a boss. Amen. And then we got a surprise. We're going to have a surprise movie night. One of our, I'll leave that alone. I ain't going to mess with Mama Bird right now. But Mama Bird going to bring her date, so we look forward to movie night. And then next Sunday will be Jersey Sunday. Now, if you don't have a jersey, I have plenty of jerseys for you. And so please let Lady Hopkins know we got your size and we got a jersey for you. Still a Nation will be in effect. We will set up. You'll have opportunity to set up Friday or Saturday for your tailgating. So Friday movie night, we're going to block off this area right by the fellowship hall so you can set up and we'll be ready for our tailgating that will take place this coming Sunday. Amen. Free breakfast for everyone and should be a good time for fellowship, food, fun, and our faith. Amen. Amen. So we're looking forward to Jersey Day next Sunday. Also, I got a note that the Titans fans want to meet, and y'all really need to meet in the conference room. So the Titans fans want to meet. Deadline for the tailgate spots will be Wednesday. So please get your funds in. Amen. Amen. Thank you so very much. Urshas, you all passed out the envelopes. Everybody got an envelope? And we're ready to give. So I certainly thank you all for your prayers. I want y'all to know I'm fine. I'm all right. I'm good. I'm working on getting my blood pressure down. But let me tell you what got it up. And we're going to move. What got it up was number one. So I get to the doctor's office, and they call me up, Mr. Hopkins, and they said, "Do you have a living will?" I said, "What this got to do with anything? A living will?" I said, "Yeah, I got a living will, but I ain't expecting nobody to cash in on it no time soon." Then the next question was, "Bro Bill," they asked me, "are you an organ donor?" I said, "Well, yes, but I ain't planning on giving up no organs today." And then the next question
was for Lady Hopkins, and she was a little slow on there, babe. You was a little slow on this one. She acted like she couldn't read it and understand it. They said, if my heart stopped or I stopped breathing, do you want to resuscitate? And she was just looking, and I'm like, I needed the North Memphis to come out in you at that point and say, heck yeah. Now that's the clean version. But I needed you to come out and be strong on that. So that's what ran it up, y'all. That's what ran it up. I just wanted y'all to know that I'm working on getting it down. So we certainly thank you for prayers. I have a card I want to read. It says, thank you for everything. It says, your thoughtfulness was appreciated more than you know. On behalf of Margie and Lily, we are so grateful to have the love and support from our church family. Our hearts are overwhelmed with gratitude. Thank you for your prayers, texts, and phone calls. Amen. God bless you, Sister Margie. Thank you so much. Our prayers are with you. All visitors, please stand. We have any visitors with us that don't mind standing? Any family and friends that don't mind standing? Miss Brenda, is that mama? Is that mama? Brenda Hall, mom is in the house. Good to see you, mom. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. Our brother, thank you so much. We thank God for all of our visitors. Come on, put our hands together. Real, real good. Sister Bill, that's your folks there. Amen. That's daughter. Amen. God bless you, daughter. Thank you so much. And all of our guests and visitors, thank you so very much. Let's lift our gift, whatever we're going to give. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 9 and 10. Let's say it together. Honor the Lord with thy substance, the first fruit of all thine increase. So shall thy barns be filled with plenty, and thy press shall burst out with new wine. Lord, we thank you so much for the gift and giver. Bless it in us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. If you will stand, starting from the rear, follow directions of our ushers, come around, give your gift. If all hearts and minds are clear, let's remember Brother White in our prayers. Brother White is in the hospital. We want to lift him in our prayers. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much. All right. If all hearts and minds are clear, let us all stand. What's her name? Echoes. Let's remember Sister Echoes in our prayer. All right, let's do what y'all, just hit something. That's the go-to there. Come on, that's good. Okay, all right. All right. Y'all feel like it? Come on, let's sing a little bit. Here we go. Yesterday, man said to me, he said, how can you smile when your world is crumbling down? I say, here's my seat. when I wanna cry. Take a look around and I see that I'm getting by, and I hold on. Change is coming. Hold on. Don't worry about a thing. Hold on. You can make it. Hold on. Everything. Some people like to worry. Some people like to hide. Some people like from the things inside. Well, it's your business. Do what you wanna do. But if it don't work out, here's what you ought to do. Now just hold on. Change is coming. Hold on. Don't worry about a thing. Hold on. You can make it. Hold on. Everything gonna be all right. La, la. 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 Now hold on. Your change is coming. Hold on. Don't worry about a thing. Hold on. You can make it. Hold on. Everything. Lord, we thank you for the close of another worship experience. We thank you for your word that reminds us that when setback shows up, we have a God who is able to restore us. We rejoice in your promise. We remember your power. And we're going to rest in your deliverance. We bless and praise your name. We lift all of our sick and shut in before you. We ask that you look upon Sister Echoes and look upon our brother White. And we ask that you will bring about healing. We ask, God, that you will continue to smile upon our bereaved family. Give them comfort. Heal them where they're hurt. We lift Marjorie and Lily before you. We lift the Bartlett family before you, and we ask, God, that you will have mercy. Now, Lord, as we make ready to go down from this place, bless our church school. Meet us again at 11 o'clock. As we leave this place, give us angels of mercy and traveling grace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. Go in peace.